Yeshua. Think about how you work through the ages in different ways, in different stages, revealing yourself, working your plans out through human vessels who yield themselves to you, souls who, for some reason, love you, have faith in you, believe in you. They may not even know much about doctrines. They may not be what we call today Bible students, or they may not go to theological college. That is not the point. The point is that God calls out and uses who he chooses. And all he wants is that we respond to that call, that we long to be fulfilled by walking in the calling that we have on our lives. Our satisfaction is all tied up in doing his will, in loving him and being satisfied in him. And it does away with that lostness. It does away with that battling to understand oneself, to have an identity, to find your tribe. None of that matters when you focus on him and his love, and you open up to his love, and his love comes in and deals with all the inner conflicts, all the unanswered questions. His love is like a healing balm that comes in and covers all these things and heals them, like ointment applied over sores or cuts or wounds or pus. All you see is the oil of his Holy Spirit. That's all you feel. That's all you know, and that's all you have to know. And underneath he works, and everything is restored and brought back to the normal. Everything comes into balance and harmony. The conflicts stop when they're under that love, when the Holy Spirit comes on you and you're under that love. He rests upon you. He finds his place within you. It's a beautiful thing. the mother love of God, gentle, comforting and warm, and peaceful. This is the spiritual peace that we long for. This is the balm for our souls, the healing for our bodies, and the renewal and awakening of our spirit to be alive to God and sensitive to His voice. Our spirit knows what to do. Our spirit hears from Him. Our spirit prays in union with His spirit. He helps us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.